Hey everybody, I'm flexing for you. I'm the real Jason Duncan, and there's a reason I'm doing that, because I'm not that kind of guy. But the reason I'm doing it is our tip for this week is strengthen your body. I've been going through the 7 habits of highly effective people all year, been specifically going through this little card deck from the Covey group called the 7 habits of highly effective people. It's got a card for every single week of the year. It's been a phenomenal thing. It's probably one of the most useful Christmas gifts my wife ever got me, in the sense that it helped make me a better person, and I'm hoping that it's making you a better person too. She got this for me for Christmas last year, and there's the content or the information on the back of the box that you can see. I highly recommend this, and as a matter of fact, I'll do a little thing like this, because I'm gonna promote this. I think that this is something everybody should do. Go out and put this in the stocking of your husband or your wife, your coworkers, your boss. This is a good thing. So we've been going through these little card decks, and I actually am doing 2 videos this week because I got a little bit behind, but there's one for every single week of the year, and these cards go over the 7 habits of highly effective people. They come out of this book right here, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People by Stephen Covey, one of the best books ever written on interpersonal relationships, and I cannot recommend it more highly. Now, we've been going through these card decks, and each week or two, they go through one of the 7 habits, and they give you activities about those 7 habits. So I'm really pushing this. Go to Amazon, wherever it is that you buy books, Barnes & Noble, pick up a copy of the book and pick up a copy of these little cards, because this particular week, it says to strengthen your body. And the reason that's the tip for this week is the activity, because it goes with the 7th habit, which is sharpen the saw. And again, if you didn't watch last week's video, sharpen saw comes from this little story about 2 men who were having a wood cutting contest with their saws, and one guy spent all his time sawing, and he sawed wood, and then the other guy would saw something, sharpen, stop and sharpen, saw something, stop and sharpen, and at the end of the day, even though he took more time off from actually sawing, he sawed more wood. So the concept for a highly effective person as a habit would be to sharpen your saw. One of the ways you do that is by keeping yourself physically fit. Now, I am not an exercise person. There's probably many gurus on Instagram, LinkedIn, and YouTube that'll tell you have to get up at 4 o'clock every morning, you gotta work out for 2 hours, and you gotta eat rice and beans, or actually those things are bad, can't eat those either, because if you're paleo, those don't work. But whatever the heck it is, they're gonna tell you how to keep your body fit. And now how you decide to do that really is up to you. Everybody needs to pick their own way. I'm not the guy that does that. I'm good if I get up and I can plank for 3 or 4 minutes a day, and I need to get back to doing that. But I don't like exercise personally. But that doesn't mean that you still shouldn't be able to keep your body fit. I'm a generally fit person, a little bit overweight, but otherwise very healthy. And I want to make sure that if I'm going to be an effective person, that I too must make sure that I'm keeping my saw sharp, whether it's my mind, heart, body, or spirit. This week, we're talking about the body. And it says here on the front about strengthening your body, it says, choose one way to build your physical capacity this week. So this week, the week where you're about to go sit down at grandma's house and eat your weight in turkey and dressing. Yes, this is probably not a good week to talk about it, but it's the week we're supposed to talk about it. It says, choose one way to build your physical capacity this week. Now, it may not just be about exercising and building muscles. It could be, as it says here, set your alarm before you go to bed. Maybe that's what you need to do, and that sets your physical capacity. And then it goes on to say, find a way to be active that challenges you. Add a new component to your exercise routine, endurance, flexibility, or strength. When you flip onto the back of the card, as always, every week, it has an ask yourself question. It says this, what's one way I could improve my strength and resilience? Just one way. What is that? Maybe it's planking. Maybe it's doing sit-ups or push-ups. Maybe it's walking. Maybe it's running. Maybe it's swimming. Whatever that happens to be, what is one way this week you can increase your physical ability, your physical strength? Physical renewal involves caring for your physical body, which is a healthy diet, sufficient rest, and regular exercise. Now, we're blowing our diet this week. We all get it. It's part of our American tradition. We understand it. We don't do it every week. Because if we did, we'd be on the show on TLC, My 600-Pound Life. But we sometimes eat a little more than we should, which is all the more reason to make sure that you're keeping your physical body fit in all other ways. Get up at the right time. Go to bed at the right time. Eat a healthy diet. Do some sort of exercise. The quote this week comes from Dr. Stephen Covey. It says, "Most of us think we don't have enough time to exercise." I know I'm guilty of that. What a distorted paradigm. We don't have time not to. Well, I hope that you can make some time to do some exercise. And if you'll commit with me, I'm going to get back to planking. I need to do that. I got up to where I was doing maybe 5 minutes a day and enjoyed it, made me feel better. And I just got away from it and I need to get back to it. So if you see me in person, in real life, and a lot of you that watch these videos, I know we know one another, ask me how the planking's going. And if I say anything other than good, you need to remind me of this video so that I can take my own advice. So again, I'm the real Jason Duncan. This is Results Through Integrity. Thank you for following me on YouTube, LinkedIn, and Instagram. I really appreciate it. It's been a great year so far on the social media content, and I appreciate you taking the time to follow me. And until next week, remember, Jesus is King.